to Missouri, Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty. You'll see Amarillo, got New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona. Don't forget Winona, San Pascal, San Bernardino. With you, get hip to this kind of tip. Baby, take that California trip. Get your kicks on.
Everything immortal must first pass away. For over half a century, Route 66 was America's main street, the way west, before interstate highways fenced folks off from homemade America. Fabled in novel song and television series, Route 66 was the road to our American dream, the symbol of freedom. From now on, you can drive from Chicago to Los Angeles without a stoplight. This is WGN Chicago.
Chicago, Illinois is one of the greatest industrial and business cities in all the world. There's no one like Chicago. And Chicago is the world's greatest railroad center. It's the world's greatest airplane center. It's the world's greatest trucking center. Chicago, Illinois is one of the world's greatest manufacturing centers. Tremendous stores and people like Sears Roebuck Company and Zenith Radio and Admiral Radio and Wrigley Chewing Gum and Mars Bars, and you can go on and on and on with Chicago. They say, if you can't find it in Chicago, you don't need it. You just don't need it if you can't find it in Chicago.
I'm leaving Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Your Greyhound through service to Los Angeles is now ready for passenger boarding through gate 23.
There ain't nothing in Chicago that a man like you can.
All aboard, please, for St. Louis, Springfield, Missouri, Tulsa, Oklahoma City, Amarillo, Albuquerque, Flagstaff, Arizona, and Los Angeles. We would like to remind you that federal regulations allow only cigarette smoking on board and then only in the rear of the coach. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Freddie Johnson. I've been with the Greyhound Corporation now about 20 years. One of the first black drivers they hired. The present time we're on Roosevelt Road on our way to Ogden Avenue, which would be beginning of Route 66. That was the only way during those years to get down to Los Angeles, California. During those years, they tell me it took about a week. But that didn't matter if you didn't have any money. It's better than walking. Americans are very transient people anyway. Everybody's trying to find the promised land, trying to find that gold. This is one country people are not satisfied with what they have. I guess that's good. That would make the country great as it is now, I assume.
But I'm tired of this dirty old city. Entirely too much work and never enough play. And I'm tired of these dirty old sidewalks. Thank God I walk off my steady job today. Turn me loose, set me free.
You said people die on the bus and nobody knew it but the bus driver. I think the Greyhound Corporation forgot what they were paying us for. They was paying us to babysit, fight off drunks, have heart attacks, hemorrhoids, and ex-wives. That's the first thing you're going to have on this job. And that's worth a lot of money. To me, it is. I got three ex-wives, alimony, and child support. But I like the job. I like the people. And I think they're being cheated. Because the same people that made this company what it is are the same ones that we're bypassing on the interstate highways right now. But the little man in this country is being forgotten. Most of the towns on this 66 were built up on account of the highway. That's gone now. The new interstates have taken over. Small towns are dying now because we're going around looking at them over our shoulders and not going in. Everybody's money conscious. Nobody's people conscious.
When my hemorrhoids flare up, I'm a believer in the rapid reliever.
Trenalane.
Across the northern third of Illinois this morning, it's gradually dying out, and by tonight, it won't even exist anymore.
Hello, I'm Orville Redenbacher with the Hoosier Crooners, asking, what's a great time for my gourmet microwave popping corn?
Summertime, 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 summertime.
My name is Michael Burns, and I've started pumping gas on Route 66 in 1919. Prior to Henry Ford, there's very few automobiles, and that they wouldn't go out in the country, they couldn't, because they'd get stuck and everything else. And therefore, Illinois decided that they had to get out of the mud. In building the hard roads of Illinois, first they had to dig out the black soil that they had, and then they poured the concrete. That's why they call it the hard road. It's made out of cement and concrete. And people came from all over the world to see how Illinois built that hard road.
Well, we had a lot of crews in here, like telephone linemen and electrical linemen, because they did move the road in various places to straighten it out as much as they could. And, well, it was just a lot of fun because we had a lot of good-looking fellows in here. And I was about 17, 18 years old when all this was going on, so you knew it was enjoyable.
I've been driving to 66 for since about 35, and it's one of the hardest lives that there is. Your truck break down on the middle of the highway out somewhere, why you had to get out and get underneath it and fix it yourself. But the only thing was wrong with 66, they called it a killer and a bloody 66. And I seen 10, 12 cars piled up in one pile, maybe a semi or two into it too. Just like hitting 10 pins, you know? It was a bloody mess on it, but it was a real good road. You know what I mean?
Highway 66 is the main migrant road. 66, long concrete path across the country, weaving gently up and down the map, from Mississippi to Bakersfield, over the red lands and the gray lands, twisting up into the mountains, crossing the divide and down into the bright and terrible desert, and across the desert to the mountains again, and into the rich California valleys.
Hey, here at the 128, you got my friend Donkey there, you're running out away from me.
You southbound on 5-5, or you northbound?
Southbound.
Okay, you come up here and catch me.
You're running the wrong way. All the good-looking ones are running north. Left.
You're on feet, Hollifoot. You got Lady Slewfoot back here talking to you. We're coming southbound, too, on this 5-5. We're picking up too much static now. We can't copy anymore.
And I was the first lady to go to work at Tyson, and we have quite a few single ladies drive by themselves now, but not really a big majority of them, probably 5%. It's of the ladies by themselves, and probably 30%, you know, man and wife teams.
West, I'd say 80%.
You think West is 80?
I'd say 80% in the West.
Of course, when I started, the men drivers was down on lady drivers. There was more of a challenge then to show them that you could do it than there is now.
When you get a family started, you know, you got little ones at the house, why, well, they've got to be always wanting this and wanting that, a pair of shoes, everything, so that's the dream we got in trucking.
The ring is from Tyson's. For every year that we don't have a wreck, they give you one diamond. It gives you an incentive not to run over anybody. A lot of people probably think that I don't drive the miles of my husband, but anybody that knows me knows that I drive on the ice, the snow, and do just like he does. So, like I said, it's real significant to me that Tyson awarded me the ring.
Yeah, we're going to be in L.A.
So let's just go ahead and put the hammer down. Then you know they're all in court right now.
Okay. Watch it. Don't get run over.
This is KXEN, St. Louis Festus, the gospel voice of Mid-America.
We're expecting miracles. We had a woman come with a tumor in her stomach. She looked pregnant. A 20-pound tumor. That's right. Big as a watermelon. Left her body overnight when we decreed healing for her. She came back the next night with a dress on she hadn't had on in some time. And God had given her a miracle. We had deaf ears open.
Won't you get hip to this timely tip? When you make that California trip?
I work usually Monday through Friday, because on weekends there tends to be a lot of women in bars, and the men know they can go into a bar and pick somebody up, so there's not that many calls. A lot of strange people go to bars, very strange, a lot of people that have problems, big problems, and for all you know, he's there to pick someone up that he can take his frustrations out on. I'm soon to move to a small town, because the way the city people react and the way they don't care about one another anymore. No one does. Seems like you live in a small community. You have a better chance of people getting to know you. But when you're in a city, no one has the chance to know you and to realize that, yes, I am an upstanding American.
I like to settle down, but they won't let me. Out of your death must be a lodestar. At every road there's always one more city. My home on the highway is gone. I'm on the run, the highway is my home.
You know, our pastor says this is the Bible Belt of the nation. I don't know if it is considered the Midwest, more or less. He says that, and I'd have to say it is. You know, in the rural areas, most people go to church. We've got a church, you know, like in this small town. I think we've got three or four churches.
That kind of thing. We try to keep women at home to raise their kids upright, and men try to make a living, and we just don't go for the whole world change.
And it's a big part of my life.
66 was still a narrow two-lane highway. Harry Truman was the man who ran the show. The bad Korean War was just beginning, and I was just 3 years too young to go. Country music hadn't gone to New York City yet. What of what he done? And Hank and Lefty crowded every jukebox. That's the way it was in 51. There's so much about the good old days I'd love to tell. There's folks around I know still remember.
And, there was cabins all along here.
So
clear up to the top of the hill.
Close together.
And we didn't have no electricity or no water, running water.
'Cause a thing like rock and roll's yet to come.
50 cents was a good price for a night's rest.
It was a
back
big
in them days.
For a driving restaurant car. Hey, that's the way it was in 51. Yeah, Hank and Lefty crowded every jukebox. Oh, Lord. That's the way it was in 51.
My name is Amy Thompson. I've been here on 66 Highway since 1928. Traffic was changed over to the new interstate in 1954. Traffic was a thick, and there was buses and everything on the road, too. Nearly everybody had truck farms, you know, and they'd sell stuff on the road, and we made baskets and chairs, and my brother had a watermelon patch, and we'd sell things on the highway. But when they changed it, they can't do that because you can't stop the traffic on the highway. The store I had to go out of business didn't get enough to do, you know, and the filling station down there. And the motels over here was tore down. It used to be called the Main Street of America here. I guess it still is to some people.
For the most part, we just pretty well think you should do it yourself. Let government mind their own business and we'll mind ours. They go by numbers. They don't go by people and individual problems. They go by what the polls say.
There again with Reagan, he's a Hollywood boy as far as we're concerned.
If we get Reagan down here with a weed hook and spread some of his manure around a little bit, he'd understand the farmer a little bit more, you know. He's lived up there where he ain't got nothing but wealth and hardwood floors to walk on, but they don't realize that when they sit down and have him $1,000 promotional dinners, that what they're eating is what we've growed for him, you know. Half of them, I guess, think that computers make them or machines, but those steaks come from these dudes that's growed right down here that we're raising, you know, and us little guys down here, I guess they even know we exist. Of course, I know.
One item that came out in the paper talking about politics and farmers, one lady made the statement that she felt like politicians were helping the farmers too much. Said she'd go to the supermarket and buy anything she needed. So that's, you know, the way a lot of them feel about the farmers. Right.
I don't know what to tell you, but we've had outsiders, and they just couldn't make it, you know. They want to change us, and we ain't going to change.
Well, we kind of take care of one another around here. You have to survive. But later, it's nice for them to come down and visit. We welcome them as long as they don't make it a place to live. Don't tell them that.
I would say the people in the eastern states think that we're crazy living like this, but, you know, we think they are, so.
The stereotype they put on us is we're all a bunch of dumb hicks, but we're not up there living with the crazy people with the knives and the guns, you know, that run up behind you and grab your purse and nobody helps you, you know, or stab you in the back. So you can walk through the woods without worrying about somebody with white teeth coming behind you with their arm raised in the air, so to speak.
If somebody pulled a gun on me or a knife on me in the middle of New York, I don't think it'd be a soul help me. If they'd done it here, they'd be 50 on them in a second. And if I seen somebody breaking in somebody else's house, it'd be my duty. I mean, I wouldn't feel a responsibility. I'd want to do it. You know, I just wouldn't have it.
We boils right back down to it. Why, we like the country life. That's why we stay here. And I intend to stay here. If I never went back to Springfield, I wouldn't make me any difference, you know.
From the Radio Ranch, KTTS, AM and FM, Springfield, Missouri.
Good evening, sir. Lindsay for American Business Machines. A drowning incident on the Lake of the Ozarks.
KTTS News.
News, it's happening every day.
Come on and tackle the turkey. Something exciting for lunch.
You like turkey?
Love turkey.
How about bacon?
Crazy about bacon.
If you lose or find a pet animal, call KDMO KRGK at 358-2648 for assistance. And keep tuned for the next Pet Patrol.
Do you have any idea how much money?
It was not a large amount, but it was a substantial loss to a donut shop.
You have a description of the suspects?
One was tall and thin. The other one appeared to be short and stocky.
We're just a part of what makes the donuts at Sugar and Spice Donut Shop so tasty and good.
Taking the cross of Christ to the crossroads of the world, this has been Country Crossroads. Our prayer is that you'll let Jesus, the living Christ of the cross, walk every crossroad of life with you.
Railroad stations, midnight trains, lonely airports in the rain. Someone stands there with tears in their eyes. Taxi cabs leave in the night, greyhound buses with red tail lights. Someone's leaving. Someone's left behind. Well, I don't know how things got that way. Seems everywhere you look these days, somebody's always saying goodbye. Take two people like me and you. We could have made it. We just quit too soon. Oh, the two of us, we could have had it all. If we'd only turn. But that's the way love is, it seems. Just when you got a real good thing, somebody's always saying goodbye.
Down at the kitchen table to look at our latest statement from the other bank. Suddenly,
they did something wrong.
What?
Our checkbook, it won't balance. Oh, what are we gonna do?
Honey, the calculator, it's gonna blow! Look out!
We escaped unhurt. Our kitchen wasn't so lucky. That night we had to eat out, but we had no cash. We knew we had to visit the money machine at the other bank.
This can't be.
What's the problem?
The machine says we're overdrawn.
Pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come against the works of the devil. Satan, I bind you in the name of Jesus. I come against sin, sickness, disease, infirmity, drug addiction, and alcohol. I call the virtue of Christ. Body.
In a little more than an hour, I'll tell you what they are. The three songs you're going to need to know.
And we need to guard our home. We need to have strong family ties. They are. Don't mess with my children.
The Ohio Lottery's $24 million prize is going to be split eight ways. One winner says now he can afford to buy a new hearing aid, maybe two hearing aids. And after that, Harry Hemphill says maybe he'll mess around a little bit. The man, they say, propositioned a man was a policeman. You know there's more crime since air conditioning? I said there is more crime since air conditioning. What's new at Talking Bathroom Scale? It compliments you if your weight goes down. It nags you when your weight goes up. In Petaluma, California, the ugliest dog in the world contest, the winner is Tibby, a Chinese Sharpei. Ugly, ugly. Now, how to kill a church.
There are those in today's society who advocate living together without being married. They attempt to justify their action for reasons of Social Security or sex, whatever it may be. Carl Richardson talks about it in his message today entitled, The Marriage Affair. And now, Forward in Faith Radio and Power Unlimited Television presents Carl Richardson with a message for these times.
Power Unlimited, Jesus Christ the King.
Well, here we have Miami, Oklahoma. This is Little Reno, Little Las Vegas. This is where everybody comes to get married for the second, third, fourth time sometimes.
Sometimes seventh.
Yes, we did. We had a fellow in here named George. George was back for his seventh go at it. He brought a lady that was back here at her third go at it, and they weren't real serious about the whole thing, so he told us that if it didn't work out, he'd come back here to marry one of us, you know. So it's an original way to get married around here. It's not the usual go to the church and wear the white dress and the marriages, and so it takes a little of the edge off. They just want a nice, quiet wedding, you know, so they can go off and try and get started again, you know, get a little happiness a second time.
Okay, we have got a blood test. That takes you about 15 minutes.
They literally do it on the lunch hour. They come in here and they say, how fast can you get this done? We've only got 45 minutes and we got to get back to work. And he comes in, he's been working on the cars, he's got grease up and down him all over the place, you know, and he's got his screwdriver on this side and his wrench on this side, and here she comes in and she's, you know, literally putting the laundry basket down, you know, just hurry up, get me married and get me out of here.
Okay, first we'll give you just a brief introduction going way back in time, in the beginning. That was a long time ago. Even then, God saw that it was not good for the man to live alone. So God performed the first marriage in the Garden of Eden, and angels was witness to that marriage. And God and angels are witness to your marriage today. And we simply continue what God began in the Garden of Eden.
$15, please.
Were blue, her hair was auburn, her smile was like an angel fair.
Thank you very much. Go right on back and she'll do your test.
Okay, after 100 years you can get a divorce. It won't cost you a penny. Okay, be free of charge.
I do.
I do.
One night I took a ride just across that line. Picked her up in a pickup truck and she broke that heart of mine. Her mama said no, she's Mona's daughter. But we got married on the Oklahoma border.
Now some very important words. Having pledged your faith in and your love to each other, and then having sealed your marital marriage vows by giving and receiving the rings, I pronounce you husband and wife in the presence of God.
Yeah, we got married on the Oklahoma border.
'66, down to Tulsa. They saw the oil derricks in the town, on the edge of the town. Oil derricks, black, and the smell of oil and petrol in the air. It was so big and so strange, it frightened them.
Coming to you live from Kane's Ballroom in downtown Tulsa on KBO Radio, Johnny Lee Wills and all the boys.
As I look
the letters that you wrote to me. It's you that I'm thinking of as I read the lines that to me were so sweet.
You're never gonna find a winner in a bar. Never. You need a little healthier atmosphere than stale cigarette smoke and liquor. They're all there because they got a problem. They're lonely, they've had their marriage of 5 or 10 years bust up, or they're out fooling around and they're gonna get caught, and then the whole world's gonna fall apart. The ones who drink heavy and hard don't last long. They've got to have a few drinks to loosen up and be what they think they ought to be. It is a fantasy world. They can be John Wayne shooting bad guys. Imitation is the most sincere form of flattery, because out there everybody's a cowboy. They've got their boots and their jeans and their cowboy belt. They're wearing their Stetson hat. They've got everything but the spurs.
They all ask me, hey, why do you drink? And why must you live out these old songs that you've wrote? Stop and think it over. Now put yourself in my unique position. If I get stoned and sing all night long, it's a family tradition. Lordy, I have loved some ladies, and I have loved Jim Lee, and they both tried to kill me back in 1973.
Boy, we had one party. You can't ever have another one like it. I mean, about 3-4 days later, I woke up, or I sobered up, I guess. I mean, it was beer cases all over the place. It was whiskey bottles. And I got up and I fooled around and found my keys to my car, and I said, man, I'm leaving, I gotta go. Started to go out and get in the car, and she come with me. I said, there's no more party. I said, I'm going home. She said, not without me, ain't. I said, oh, yes, I am. And she says, no, you ain't. And she pulled out a piece of paper, and it was a marriage license. She says, where you go home, I go home.
Your life is all etiquette. We're all going to die. Hallelujah. But down there in the belly of the wave, Jonah began to come to his senses. And he said, he looked around at the bars that had him surrounded. He's looking at the ribcage, and that whale is what he's looking at. He said, out of the belly of hell, cried I. Hallelujah, God, it's out of my hands. My life is a mess. My life is a shambles. I realize, God, it's either now or never. It's either turn to you or perish in the belly of this whale. And out of the belly of hell, it cried unto the Lord. And God heard him in the accepted time. God looked down upon his affliction. God began to move, and he moved on the old fish, and he called him to vomit him out on the dry land. He said, salvation is from the Lord. Some folks, it amazes me. You can talk to them and say, this is what you're looking for. Preacher, I don't want anything to do with it. I don't want to act like that. I don't want to dress like that. And when God gets through, they're more than willing to come and to pray and talk to God. What this world needs is a good old-fashioned dose of the Holy Ghost. They need a good old-fashioned dose of repentance. Turning to the truth of the living God. That's right, the whole world needs this. The whole world has no place else to turn. It's on a downhill slide to hell. And there's no
all of them that believe in my name, they shall speak with new tongues. Just begin to let it just flow from your lips right now. This young man, just begin to speak it out right now. In the name, that's the power of the Holy Spirit right there. That's it. Don't stop. Just speak it out. Put audible voice. That's the Holy Ghost, my brother. Stay here, Lynn. Just begin to let it flow, Walter. Not one word of English. Just begin to let it flow. That's the power. That's it. In the name of Jesus. Don't be afraid. In the name of Jesus.
Rivers of running living water flow forth from your innermost being in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Just begin to flow. Don't be afraid. Just pray in the Spirit. That's it. Let those sorrows go. Just let them flow. In the name of Jesus. Just let them flow.
In the name of Jesus, we come to you this morning with thanksgiving in our lips. We come to you, Lord, with praise in our hearts. Lord, we come before your presence with singing. We worship and magnify your name. And then we proclaim victory this day.
Many a month have come and gone since I wandered from my home in those Oklahoma hills where I was born. Many a page of life has turned, many a lesson I have learned, but I feel like in those hills I still belong.
Altogether, I've barbered about in this part of the country for 50 years. I started in 1934. My business is pretty well all regular local customers. Of course, I would pick up a few strangers from the highway occasionally. Been here all back during the old depression days, the drought and depression. And then just last week when the papers come out showing some of the Dust Bowl days and stuff, you know, they talked like it was some places getting back almost equal to the Dust Bowl days back in the 30s.
Of course, we had sand that blew, but our dust came from the panhandle of Oklahoma, Texas, Colorado, Kansas. But up there, it just blowed out in big holes. It would cover up fences, barns, and everything else. You know, it was, that country does move around. The sky would start getting dark, darker, 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 and then it just cut the sun plumb off. Well, I don't know how many years was it, Barbara, that we didn't make it.
My brothers and my sisters are stranded on this road, a hot and dusty road that a million feet have trod. Rich man took my home and drove me from my door, and I ain't got no home in this world anymore.
66 is the path of a people in flight, refugees from dust to shrinking land. From the thunder of tractors and shrinking ownership. From the desert's slow northward invasion. From the twisting winds that howl up out of Texas. From the floods that bring no richness to the land and steal what little richness there is. From all of these, the people are in flight. And they come into 66 from the tributary side roads, from the wagon tracks and the rutted country roads. 66 is the mother road, the road of flight. If we can only get to California, where the oranges grow before this here old jug blows up, if only can.
After rolling through a lovely garden, as day was drawing to a close, I beheld a tragic story. I saw a teardrop on the road. It should have been a tear of gladness, but deep inside the sorrow shows. A false goodbye, life is shattered, drop on the road. The tear will dry, the rose will wither, when spring and winter comes and shattered with just a teardrop on the road.
KXY, Dave and Dan with Atlanta.
Now wait a minute, they're still tinkling.
I know. Well, excuse me.
Quite a party.
Whoa. 40 to 640, monthly $5.99 to $6.28 per bushel.
66 out of Oklahoma City. El Reno and Clinton going west on 66. Hydro, Elk City, and Texola. And there's an end to Oklahoma.
32 cotton in southwestern Oklahoma. Average 60 and 3/4 cents per pound. Live rollers for 31 cents per pound. Eggs, they are 74 cents. They needed 58.
Its name, a symbol of terror, the deadliest killers in the West. Now they were all together, gangs and guns, ready to take over Carson City on the eve of the world-famous Corbett Fitzsimmons championship fight, while a beautiful woman played for the biggest stakes of all.
I had to see you, Linda.
Oh, I've dreamed about us, Brett, just the two of us together, somewhere, anywhere. Then I tried not to think about you at all.
Don't think about it. Don't even talk about it.
The 66 is the artery, main artery of the United States. Because when you say Highway 66, everybody knows what Highway 66 is. Then the state and federal government finally decided that they was going to isolate another little town. And they isolated us. And at June the 15th in 81, I think, at 1:15, the traffic stopped. And I mean, it stopped. The highway was going around, and there was no sign of anything that there was a little town anywhere. And it went from about 150 to 200 cars to hour to none. I don't think there's any way that these little towns can survive. A few of them can maybe hang in there, the few businesses. But when you have geared yourself up to rely on tourists, and if you don't have enough local people that eats out, especially in the cafe business, then you might as well quit.
Amarillo by morning, up from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I've got on. When that sun is high in that Texas sky, I'll be bucking at the county fair. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo, I'll be there.
I-40 means nothing. Really and truly, I-40 means it's just another freeway that you get from one point to another as fast as possible. Man, those cars are moving on that.
Lost my wife and a girlfriend somewhere along the way.
Now, 66, you could stop if you wanted to, or you keep going if you wanted to. But not I-40. Mm-mm. You get on there and you move and hope you don't see a little black and white car that says you've moving too fast. It's just another old freeway. Only it's not very free, really, when you get too paying for it.
Amarillo by morning, up from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I've got on. I ain't got a dime, but what I got is mine. I ain't rich, but Lord, I'm free. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's where I'll be. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's where I'll be.
Got any cowboys here tonight? Do we have any cowgirls? Thank goodness there's still a difference in Amarillo, Texas. On a highway deep within the heart of Texas, just about as lost as I could be. Driving around in circles, trying to find the border. Texas was as far as I could see. And I stopped and flagged me down a state policeman. And I said, my patience growing mighty thin. Then you helped me get the hell out of Texas. He just flashed me some old Lone Star Texas green. He said, you can't get the hell out. We raise hell just like you'd raise a crop. Well, it started with the Alamo and ain't gonna never stop. As long as there's a Houston and Austin, Amarillo, Lubbock, Dallas, and Fort Worth, boy, you can't get the hell out of Texas. It's a hell-raising center of the earth. Now, yeah.
Bobby's gonna try our 72-ounce steak this evening. Bobby, you've got 1 hour in which to eat this entire meal. If you do so, we're going to give it to you on the house. Compliments of the Big Texan Steak Ring.
66, across the panhandle of Texas. Shamrock and McLean, Conway and Amarillo. Little kid comes in late to school. Teacher says, why are you late? Kid says, had to take a heifer down, got her bread. Teacher says, couldn't your old man do it? Kid says, sure he could, but not as good as the bull.
Dear sweet mama on the phone. Let her sing the light, thank God for joy. I'm a chain man, I'm a good old boy. Mama, I ain't never coming home. As long as there's a Houston and Austin, Tyler, Beaumont, Dallas, and
Well, I'm DeWitt Elmore, raised on the farm and ranch area, cattle, cowboying. There was two things I could have done. One is prostitution, but there wasn't any male prostitution in this country. I understand it goes on today, but not back in my day. And so the other was the pawn business. I had a friend of mine, he's a district judge now, still in Lubbock, Texas, to read me the complete law on pawn shops. There wasn't any. That was for me. Anything to keep out the bureaucracies of the United States government and all other governments controlling my life. I like to be independent and like to see everybody else cut their own rut, so to speak. You know, I frontiered this country and went across the prairies when we had to cut our own rut. And I am proud of the fact that I am a true Texan and never signed the back of a government check. And, you know, we try in the United States to take care of you from the womb to the tomb. And we're getting tired of that, as taxpayers are. So we'd like to change it. We've got now the best president we've ever had in the United States in my lifetime. We do have kind of an idiocy-type governor, but the governor of the state of Texas. About all that follows him is what they call the minorities, the blacks, the Hispanics, the queers, and such and so forth. They call me an extreme right. At least I'm right. I'd like for Texas to square off and leave the rest of the United States, but it'll never be. We'd have more wealth and maybe we'd have it made. There's a good bit of money around Texas, all cattle and farming corn, cotton, and so forth. So we'd get rid of a lot of the riffraff that comes in here. We're the high grounds, Texas, the high grounds for all the dirt to come to, you know.
Our cruise missile will be tested a second time over Western Canada tomorrow. Moscow is really squirming. Have you been listening? Really worried about our president's Star Wars defenses. In today's Moscow news, the chief spokesman for the Kremlin said that they will not allow it. Moscow imagines that we're going to let them have the sky to themselves and everything under it. Not this president. By the way, President Reagan wants to talk to you tonight.
I found out early that most men, regardless of cause or need, aren't willing. They blink an eye or draw a breath before they pull a trigger. I won't.
You can get this one.
This is a test. This station is conducting a test of the emergency broadcast system. This is only a test. If this had been an actual emergency, you would have been instructed where to tune in your area for news and official information.
Thank you, Bob. Start off with Dave, who doesn't believe what he's hearing. Good morning, Dave.
Good morning. If I understand the general correctly, he believes that civilization could survive a nuclear exchange. Is that correct?
I haven't said that yet, but I do say it.
Just reach over and lay your hand on the radio now as we pray, as we go off now.
Aren't you weary of the burger wars? Well, come try something better.
If we have nuclear war, the living will be jealous of the dead.
I've been warped by the rain, driven by the snow. I'm drunk and dirty, don't you know? I'm still. Smuggle some smokes and folks from Mexico, baked by the sun every time I go to Mexico. And I'm willing. Been kicked by the rain, robbed by the sleet, had my head stoned in, but I'm still on my feet and I'm willing. And I'm willing. I've been from a Tucson to Tucumcari, to Hatchapeena, Tonopah, driven every kind of rig that's ever been made. Driven the back row so I wouldn't give way. You give me weed, whites and wine, and show me a sign, and I'll be willing to be moving. Out on the road late at night, I see my pretty Alice in every headlight. Alice, Dallas, Alice. I've been from a Tucson to Tucumcari, Atchipee to Tonopah, driven every kind of rig that's ever been made. Driven the back row so I wouldn't get whites and white. And you show me a sign, I'll be willing.
I love Tucumcari, and Tucumcari's always been good to me. And I feel comfortable here. And I prospered in Tucumcari. Now, this is the center between east and west traffic. And people have been coming here. This is their stopover between Flagstaff and Oklahoma City. It's 500 miles each way. And that way they don't travel too long a day. During the Depression, there were lots and lots of families that came through. And times were better in 60. And then when about in 80, we found they were going to have our bypass. And everybody got worried, and money got tight. People didn't know what to do. And we had the, hippies, I guess you would call them. They expected you to give them food and lodging. But the travelers we have today is quite different from that. We have people looking for work. Some of them know where they're going, some of them don't. They just go from one place to another. Now, like tonight, I have two different couples that are transient. And they're really needing help.
Well, we're from Poplar Bluff, Missouri. We haven't been able to find a doggone thing to do. All we've done today is just walk. But now we'll go out tomorrow and look some more. I don't, they gotta be work around here someplace. But it seems like I can't be at the right place at the right time. And, you know, I will say this. We've got some good folks in this country that have given us some work to do, and they don't question, they don't say a word. We've done a lot of yard work and whatever they might have to be done. And we're all hurting. So we've got to stick together and work together. That's the only way we're going to make it. I'm 53 years old, and I only got one thing I can say for sure. As long as that man up there lets this old man feel good, he gonna work. And I hope whoever hears this will let us know.
I wish your buck was still silver back when the country was strong. It was back before Elvis was born, before the Vietnam War came along, before the Beatles and yesterday, when a man could still work, still would. The best of the free life's behind us now, and the good times are over for good. I'm rolling down a hill like a snowball, it's headed for hell. with no kind of chance for the flag or the Liberty Bell. I wish a Ford and a Chevy would still last 10 years like they should. The best of the free life's behind us now, and the good times are over for us. I wish Coke was still cola, and a joint was a bad place to be. It was back before Nixon lied to us all on TV, before microwave ovens and a girl could still cook and still would. The best of the free life behind us now, and the good times are over for good.
Of our traditional music that we have nowadays, regardless if it's modern music, there is a love of country expressed in them. Due to our mom and dad, grandpa's water, being from Mexico. So we are a culture, or cultures that we have living in society, the American society. We're slowly being assembled into the society through the biggest factor, which is intermarriage, which a lot of people fail to see. Now, the reason that I know this, I've performed literally hundreds of marriages, and people don't realize that there is a huge, because this is one of the purposes that our people have. We will assimilate into the American culture, comes hell or high water. The Spanish man married the Anglo woman, number one, immediately gives him a higher standing, because he is married to a güerita, you know, little blonde from up here. And the same way applies with the women. She goes downtown and then somebody stops her and she says, hey, look, here's my marriage certificate, I'm married to an American. She will not be bothered anymore. As opposed to if she were just a Chicana woman, she'd be questioned, where's your papers, when you come in, all this kind of stuff. But that marriage license is a magic item.
¿Le gustaría probar cornflakes que no se suavicen ni se deshagan muy pronto? Y compre Country Cornflakes.
Many scientists now believe that extraterrestrial life exists. Perhaps hundreds or even thousands of civilizations. We don't know about inhabited planets, but we know about heaven.
Dear Tia Chucha, I have a problem and I would like some advice. I met a young boy in church and went with him for 2 months. One time he called me and said he would like to mess around with me in my friend's lowrider at church. So I went to church that night. He stood me up and talked to some niña, you know, some cutie. I don't like her, and he talked the whole night. He knows I hate her. So I guess he wanted to make me jealous. Got a freaky D scratch and a rap from double L. Put it both together, now we're raising hell. I'm a true hip hopper, lightning lips, your party rocker. Now I see you dancing and I see those smiles. Let the big deep rap to your wife. Let's get on down to the top of this town.
Yeah, go ahead and stop that pickup.
The general trend of the police is if they see two, three, four young men of Chicano extraction seemingly in a car and making maybe a little water turn to normal, they will immediately get stopped. The police have this high pressure from the elite people to keep those bums, as they refer to them, off the streets. And this is what I cannot understand. Why, after so many hundreds of years of assimilation of our cultures, can't we get over this period of hatred? This period of, no, we're not going to let this Mexican get up here to a middle-income bracket if we can help it.
Albuquerque, where the road comes down from Santa Rosa, the people in flight from the terror behind. Strange things happen to them, some bitterly cruel and some so beautiful that the faith is refired forever.
Okay, have a good night. Thank you.
Down the gorged Rio Grande to Las Lunas and west again on 66 to Gallup. And there's the border of New Mexico. People in flight along 66, and the concrete road shone like a mirror under the sun. And in the distance, the heat made it seem that there were pools of water in the road. Danny wants a cup of water.
Well, there's something up ahead. Want to stop? Do you think it would be clean? Clean as you're going to find this godforsaken country. Well, maybe the bottled soda will be all right.
Of the Navajo Nation, the original Navajo Hour on KGAK in Gallup, New Mexico.
Navajo Shopping Center.
You asked me, okay, why a Navajo drinking? All right, then there's no job. That's the reason why. They're here, they're in town. They're becoming alcoholics, just like me, too, okay? All right, look at me. See, I went to high school, I got a job, that I'm a pipe fitter and welder. Okay, no job here, I'm just in town, drinking, too. Really, that's true, everybody else is like that now. So, okay, that's the reason why. You see a lot of these drunk Indians, that's what white people, that's what they tell us, a drunken Indian. Chasing memories with the wine, wishful thinking. Government says you got a little reservation right there. They sent us to Vietnam and they say fight for your country. That's not our country. No way, man. Here, our country's a little reservation right there, man. Here, they sent us way out overseas and they say fight for your country. That's not our country, man. No way. How come Washington D.C. or the president, they don't see it that way? And here we've been hollering about give us some money, give us some money. Our chairman goes over there and then asks for some money. Karen, They just go and they don't look at us. They turn their face. Here, we ask, we're crying, man. We say, give us some money, man. Here.
Why do they come into town? I believe it's a place of entertainment like it is to you. We go to Las Vegas for a good time. They come in for the same reason. There's a lot that's not on the reservation. It's something you need in order to live, so they come in here and buy what they need and then go home. I say out of 100%, 92% come in and buy their groceries, eat at a restaurant, probably go to the movie and some kind of entertainment and go home. We have 8% that do not have a home here or on the reservation. They're mostly, well, I think they give them the title as street people. That's the ones that drink to feel normal.
When I was a kid, I didn't know I was an Indian. I went to school, and the people who taught me at school were non-Indian. And they always were superior to Indians because they always knew what was right and what was wrong. And I didn't know anything about my history, so I didn't know I was an Indian. You know, how will I know if I'm an Indian? You know, because I wasn't wearing any feathers or anything. And these Indians on TV and the movies were like that, and the cavalry always got them, you know. I always felt inferior. It is close to what you might call getting brainwashed.
Well, if you ever plan to take a trip, just take my way. That's the highway, that's the best to get your kicks. Well, you wind from Chicago to L.A. More than 2,000 miles out away. Get your kit on Route 66.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Like we said, we'd like to welcome you to this year's edition of the 19th Annual All-Indian Rodeo Cowboys Association Championship Final here in Tobruk, Arizona, as our contingency of cowboys and cowgirls line up and salute to you.
Now the Indians are dressing up like cowboys, and the cowboys are putting leather and turquoise on, and their music sold by Lord.
The man young out of the East Kensington, Arizona. Here he is. And the man young, courtesy of the Buckwire, the horn even on odds for the high.
When he smelled the smoke and the sandals, he slipped back his hair.
And your commander
opened up his cape. He played Cherokee fiddle.
Here we go with Henry Kane and our Gideon and you.
As good a whiskey never let Jesus play. No, Jack Daniels, he never let Jesus play.
believe, ye trust in lying words.
This is not Gio Gerard's revival.
I don't call Brother Gerard.
This is Jesus' revival.
Did Jesus?
And what we give?
But in the ashes,
we're giving to Jesus.
Jesus, but in the adole.
And preaching and bringing the light of the gospel to a dark area. If this is important to you, then you don't mind putting your money in to help us to go on. God's given you what you've got. And if you'll give it back to God, God will bless you.
Degrees.
Alcohol is in safety here at KAFF Flagstaff. News coming up from ABC.
We have a call for Aldine Cunningham. Are you a caller? Are you there?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Good evening. May I help you?
I can just barely hear you.
Okay, dear. Can you hear me now? Can you hear
Hello?
Me now? Hello?
Caller?
Yes.
Do you have a question?
Yes, I do. I was wondering... that I'm interested in, but I know them more as friends, and I was wondering if any relationship would develop more than friendship with
them. I do not see psychically, dear, that there will be a marriage with either one of these men. They're very nice men, particularly the one that's the shorter of the two. I like him a lot. Good man. But I feel like that he likes you a lot as a friend. He does not have marriage in mind, not with you or with anyone else. Not that he's opposed to it, but he seems to have projected it for a distant future. Take it easy now, because it's going to be, I know you'll be anxious, but take it easy.
I think she was in a hurry to get back to the stove or something there. We're going to take one more real quick, and then we'll have some music for you from Don Williams. But we have another caller on the line. Caller?
Bomber in the California's Mojave Desert near Edwards Air Force Base.
The giant jet crashed when the crew failed to distribute fuel evenly in the aircraft during a low-altitude, low-speed test. No one knows why it wasn't done.
It was a human error.
While the suicide rate among the rest of the population has remained the same, the teenage suicide rate has risen dramatically. Debbie, whose brother Jim committed suicide, thinks this has something to do with the greater pressures on young people today.
I was very fortunate because I had a wise nun in junior high school. She told us this is not going to be the best time of your life. In fact, if you make it to the age of 20, give yourself a pat on the back.
Good morning, boys and girls. It's now time for us to say the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. Please stand. Janice, would you please lead us this morning?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We will have our minute of silence.
As I said to you tonight, the jukebox player, a song about the wild side of life. As I listened to the words you were saying, it brings memories when I was a trusted wife. It wasn't God who made honky-tonk angels as you wrote in the words of your song. Too many times married men think they're still single and have caused many a good girl.
May's face was gay when the door opened and the two uniformed truck drivers entered. Hi, sister. I won't be a sister to no man, said May. They laughed and May laughed. What'll it be, boys? Oh, a cup of Java. What kind of pie you got? Pineapple cream and banana cream and chocolate cream and apple. Give me the apple. No, wait. What's that big, thick one? May picked up the pie and smelled it. Pineapple cream, she said. Well, chop a hunk out of that.
Tom Dent,
my cousin
Ricky.
I did pretty good this morning. Hey, four whole eggs.
Oh, you did? Four eggs?
Yeah.
Dang.
Okay, well, not go anywhere this morning.
The weather started changing the other night.
You know, I kind of laugh at this Marlboro image, but at the same time, it kind of upsets me a little bit.
A lot of people also look at the cowboy, you know, as a lower class of people, which we're not a lower class of people. We're just as intelligent as the next person. Maybe we're not in their field, but they wouldn't be in our field either.
The values of the people in town, I don't understand at all. They're just... It's a keep up with the Jones type of a deal, and they're just striving for more petty things. They're better stereos, they're better home entertainment systems, and them things to me have no value whatsoever.
They live a TV commercial life. That's what they rate everything. I'm just waiting for the day that somebody unplugs their TV and what they're gonna do.
Someone in Washington has done something about the weather, and from now on you'll be able to get the weatherman's latest forecasts, come rain or shine. The Office of Censorship has decided that no longer will it be necessary for the American people to forego the pleasure of discussing that most talked about subject. And the lifting of the ban is being interpreted that the high command now believes this country is free of the threat of any big-scale enemy air action.
Steve, this is a young man's war.
I know how you feel, honey. But with my training, the Navy needs me. You may not hear from me for some time, but you'll be in my thoughts wherever I am.
Women have invaded another field usually reserved for men. 35 women butcherettes started training today in San Francisco in a step to relieve the shortage caused by the departure of 1,000 male butchers for the armed services. That's the news.
This is a program of blues and boogie-woogie music, heartache music mostly. It's the deep down inside feelings of men and women put into half notes and quarter notes.
Hello, Louie. This is your wife again. Listen, you. Stay out of those pubs and away from those barmaids. Do they jitterbug there, honey? I bet they don't dance as nice as we do, though, and I bet they're not half as pretty. Are they, honey? Well, I guess this is about all I can think to talk about for now. Except that I love you, and I'm waiting for you to come home, honey. Fish gotta swim, bird gotta fly. I've gotta love a man till I die. Can't help loving that man of mine. Maybe he's lazy.
New and improved types of atomic bombs are loaded in the bomb bays of C-29, all ready for the evaporation of four Japanese cities. 17,000 Japanese at Chili Lake Segregation Center in California are quietly observing funeral rites for their relatives back home in atomic-level Hiroshima.
The average World War II veteran saw approximately 40 days of active combat. The average Korean veteran saw about 3 months. Where in Vietnam, in a 13-month tour, the guy saw 360 days of close jungle combat. It takes its toll, especially when you come out of a peacetime society like ours is. Ours hadn't been to war for 20 years. So you had a whole generation of guys that weren't adapt to war, and you put them in a totally insane situation. They kick them loose and put them back out in general society, and they're expected to behave. You know, there you were. You were in the jungle. You were walking and whatever. Then all of a sudden, your orders come down. You're cut. Hey, let's go home. Bang, you flew home the next day. That night, you were cut loose. Go home. Have a nice time. Well, then you're home with the family, and you're having a good time. And, you know, like currently, our prisons are full of Vietnam vets that have just gone bananas. I mean, these guys are warped, a lot of them. A lot of guys that really worked on their head mentally. I have a friend of mine that was very, quote, normal. And then one day, a Vietnamese started giving him a bad time, and he killed him. And now, currently, he's in San Quentin doing life for first-degree murder. And it's hard, you know? I mean, he should have seeked out a place like this to where he could hide. It's a very quiet, serene place up in the Black Mountains, the high desert of Arizona. When they opened Interstate 40 and quit using Route 66, then the town just basically died. It killed it. It's just a quiet place to live where you can slow down, where your life can go back to normal. Along with the flies.
Flies struck the screen with little bumps and droned away. The compressor chugged for a time and then stopped. On 66, the traffic whizzed by, trucks and fine streamlined cars and jalopies. And they went by with a vicious whiz.
Back in 1927, I had a little farm and I called that heavenly. Rain quit and the wind got high and a black old dust storm filled the sky. And I swapped my farm for a Ford machine and I poured it full of this gas Eileen and I started rocking and rolling over the mountains out towards the old Peach Bowl. Way up yonder on a mountain road, I had a hot motor and a heavy load. I was going pretty fast, I wasn't even stopping, bouncing up and down like popcorn popping. Had a breakdown, I'm sort of a nervous bust down of some kind. It was a feller there, a mechanic feller, said it was engine trouble. Way up yonder on a mountain curve, it's way up yonder in the piney wood, and I give that rolling Ford a shove, and I was gonna coast as fur as I could. Commenced coasting, picking up speed, was a hairpin turn. I didn't make it. Man alive, I'm telling you, the fiddles and the guitars really flew. That Ford took off like a flying squirrel, and it flew halfway around the world. Scattered wives and children's all over the side of that mountain.
$250,000 people over the road. 50,000 old cars. Wounded, steaming. Wrecks along the road, abandoned. Well, what happened to them? What happened to the folks in that car? Did they walk? Where are they? Where does the courage come from? Where does the terrible faith come from?
My name is Michael Wilson, and I presently live here in Katy's, so I prospect out in the area. And I was back in 1975, abducted by higher intelligence in Fremont, California, and I didn't know anything about them at the time. And they gradually got closer and closer to me until finally I was wakened within chambers where I believe was inside the Earth. I was able to see a giant spaceship with people descending down from the spaceship on like a gravity beam of some kind. The hull of their ship was electrochemically grown under great pressure. And there was a 4-foot woman with a golden blonde hair that had a strange board device with a glowing pin. They were from the Andromeda Galaxy. They are your angelic emissaries that come down from higher creation. They can come in the appearance of man, like how it's written in the Bible, but they can also appear in their whole light form. Right now, they're interested in the plan of rescue and evacuation. They're concentrating their efforts in areas of zones of destruction where they know there will be great earthquake catastrophe or flood, tidal wave, that kind of thing.
From the Crystal Cathedral in Garden Grove, California.
There's trouble in paradise.
Hold it! He said the stench of that city, the sin of that city, has come up in my nostrils a stink.
L.A. is still a pencil town. We have all the television shows here.
Great day in the morning, in the afternoon.
Free cocaine over here. I'm going to take this chainsaw, start it up, take the throttle all the way open, juggle it while it's running at full speed with two other objects. This is extremely dangerous. Please, don't anybody try this. Step back, I'm really shitty at it.
I'm sick of not being able to take my family to a movie unless I want to have them exposed to nudity, homosexuality, and the glorification of narcotics and liquor.
Hallelujah! It's a city of dreams, but it's not a city of show business. The ice cream business outgrosses films by 400%.
You're petty and you finally came out.
This is your life.
The decay spreads over the state, and the sweet smell is a great sorrow on the land. And in the eyes of the people, there is the failure. And in the eyes of the hungry, there is a growing wrath. In the souls of the people, the grapes of wrath are filling and growing heavy for the vintage.
Have a nice doomsday.
Set up the sound.
Recording it? My voice?
If you ever plan to motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66.
To be perfectly honest, I didn't realize when I wrote the song that I had written a song about such a legendary highway, Route 66. It's something that will be indelibly ingrained in the minds of everyone in the United States. Route 66 will remain forever.
Hey, you go through St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty, you'll see. Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Winona, Kingman, Boston, San Bernardino, won't you get hip to this timely tip? When you make that California trip, get your kicks on Route 66. Get your kicks on Route 66. Get your kicks on Route 66.
Everyone ready? Okay.
God bless America again. You see all the trouble that she's in. Watch her pretty face, dry her eyes and then God bless America again.
God, I sure do wish you bless America again. You know, like you did way back when it all first began. You blessed her then, Lord, but we just sort of kind of took it for granted. Never did ask again. So just hold her hand, God. That's all. And if she should stumble, please don't let her fall. You know, I don't understand everything I read and hear about what's wrong with America today. But when you don't have a lot of book learning, I guess there's lots of things you don't understand. Just let me say this, God. She's been like a mother to me. And everything that I am or hope to be, I owe to her and to you.